Shalom. Thank you for tuning in to Shalom Prayer Teleconference. I'm your prayer host, Evangelist King. And again, dear heart, remember to tune in again Monday through Friday, 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, by calling conference line 712-432-0075 and entering participant code 422080. Again, thank you for joining in. Now, today's prayer point is entitled Great Deliverance. You know, Psalms 18, chapter verse 50, reads, "Great deliverance give he to his king, and show mercy to his anointed, to David, and to his seed forevermore." You know, even in Psalms, through the prophet David, the Lord God promised to give us deliverance. And what is great deliverance? Great deliverance is when your body, soul, and spirit are free from all forms of demonic penetration or manipulation. Great deliverance, dear heart, is used especially as warfare prayers during deliverance exercises. And so today we're going to take this time to do some personal deliverance exercises. So if you're one of those who are serious about getting set free, body, soul, and spirit, then I advise you to sit comfortable, focus your attention on the Lord Jesus Christ, to avoid distraction, and if they come, do not concentrate on them, because it's really the enemy do not want you to get set free. Also, confess any known sin to the Lord. Ask the Lord to bring your memory to the legal ground or the open doors that forces of spiritual wickedness are using to gain entrance into your life. Enter into this period with aggressive prayer. I mean, you must pray aggressively. You know, in the natural, if a robber comes and try to break in our house and we happen to be there, we will be very aggressive at that robber and command that robber to leave our home. You do have a spiritual robber, dear heart, and you need to get aggressive in your prayer. All these prayer points are to be said with holy anger. They are to be said violently and with a determined aggression towards the spiritual enemy, not toward any human being now, but towards the spiritual enemy. You know, great deliverance, according to Psalms 18, verse 50, is a function of freedom from sin, self, and Satan, and it also includes having authority and dominion over all things. This will be our law if we draw a battle line with anti-deliverance forces. Now, deliverance is the act of setting free from every form of bondage. The bondage can be in the form of yokes, covenants, curses, spiritual chains, and also habits and addictions. Great deliverance can only be said to have taken place when we are genuinely delivered from sin and translated into the light of His dear Son, according to Galatians 1st chapter, verse 13. Now, when flesh has no dominion over us through Jesus Christ. Now, if we give ourselves to the study of God's word, dear heart, and we continue to live a holy and maintain an aggressive spiritual life, victory is sure. Our victory is sure and our deliverance is sure. So right now, let's take some time first to do some confessions. Judges 15 chapter verses 7 through 9. And Samson said unto them, "Though you have done this, yet will I be avenged of you, and after that I will cease." And he smote them with hip and thigh with a great slaughter. And he went down and dwelt in the top of the rock Etham. Then the Philistines went up and pitched in Judah and spread themselves in Lehi. Genesis 45, verse 7, "And God sent me before you to reserve you a posterity in the earth and to save your lives by a great deliverance. 1 Chronicles 11:14, and they set themselves in the midst of that parcel and delivered it and slew the Philistines, and the Lord saved them by a great deliverance. You see, dear heart, today we want to experience the great deliverance of our Lord, because he said that he gives his king, and we are king in the eyesight of God. God himself is the king, and he is the king of kings. A king is an individual who has submitted their will to the Lord, has received the Lord in their heart, and they live by every word that proceeds out of God's mouth. They have really chosen to follow and to be a disciple of Christ Jesus. And the Lord promised us great deliverance. So again, as I said, to participate with me in this deliverance exercise, let me reiterate again what you need to do. Sit comfortably. Focus your attention only on the Lord Jesus Christ, because he is your deliverer. Avoid distraction, because the enemy is going to try to send distraction, but don't concentrate on them. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Confess any known sin to the Lord as the Holy Spirit reveals to you. Then ask the Lord to bring to your memory any legal ground or open door that the forces of spiritual wickedness may be using to gain an entrance into your life. And then you enter this period right now with aggressive prayer. After I say the prayer point, you repeat after me aggressively. Because all the prayer points need to be said with an holy anger, violently, and with determined aggression towards the enemy. So are you ready? Well, let's go. Because I too need great deliverance, just like you. Say, I release myself from every ancestral pollution in Jesus' name. Say, I release myself from every spiritual pollution emanating from my parents' religion in the name of Jesus. Say, I break and loose myself from every idol and related association in the name of Jesus. Now, dear heart, don't forget to say it with a holy anger. Say it violently and with a determined aggression towards the enemy. Say, I release myself from every dream pollution in Jesus' name. You happen to be having sex in your dream, affairs in your dream, a man or woman coming to you, courting you in your dream, you having children in your dream. It's like you marry in your dream. Say, I release myself from every dream pollution now in Jesus' name. Say, let all the rivers, trees, forests, evil companions, evil pursuers, pictures of dead relatives, snakes, spirit husbands, spirit wives, master race, manipulating against me in my dream, be completely destroyed now by the power in the blood of the Lord Jesus. Some of you have dreams of your dead loved ones, and you think that's God allow you to see your dead loved one. Dear heart, no. That is not God. That is the spirit of death, a demon spirit whose responsibility is to bring death to those that receive it. So today, say, I cut myself loose from the spirit of death. Leave me right now in Jesus' name. Say, I command every evil plantation in my life, come out with all your roots now in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, lay your hands on your stomach and keep repeating this emphasized area. I command every evil plantation in my life, Come out with all your roots now in the name of Jesus. Dear Lord, say, evil strangers in my body, come all the way out of your hiding places now in the mighty name of Jesus. Say it, dear Lord. Evil strangers in my body, come out, all of you, all the way out of your hiding places now. Come out in the mighty name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus against you. You no longer have any legal right in my body. Come out now in Jesus' name. Say, dear heart, let all avenues of eating or drinking spiritual poisons be closed in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, you need to say that. You don't know where you have been to a restaurant. They may have given you some type of, well, first of all, the kitchen help may be into their car, sneaking things into the food. You leave with an upset stomach, thinking it's just merely an upset stomach. You claim your stomach hasn't been right since you went to a such-and-such restaurant and you have eaten, and your stomach haven't been feeling good. You just haven't been feeling good. Dear heart, you have eaten and drinking spiritual poison. So right now say, let all avenues of eating or drinking spiritual poison, I command those avenues to be closed now in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, Jesus promised that he would give us great deliverance, but we have something to do. We must open up our mouth and confess the words of God. Say, dear heart, I cough out and vomit any food eaten from the table of the devil in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, begin to cough them out now. Vomit them out in faith. Prime the expulsion right now in Jesus' name. Say, come out of me right now. Any food eaten from the table of the devil, I vomit you out now. I cough you out by faith in Jesus' name. Come out. Come out now in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, say, let all negative materials circulating in my bloodstream be evacuated now in Jesus' name. Dear heart, let's say that again. Repeat aggressively. Towards the enemy, all negative materials you are circulating in my bloodstream, I command you to be evacuated. Come out now in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, say, and this is by faith, dear heart, I drink the blood of Jesus. That means I receive the blood of Jesus. Dear heart, physically swallow and drink it in faith and keep doing this for some time. Just swallow. I drink, swallow the blood of Jesus. By faith, I drink only the blood of Jesus. Paul, swallow in Jesus' name. Swallow. You're swallowing the blood of Jesus into your system, and the blood of Jesus rotating throughout your system, driving out illegal aliens that is hidden in the bloodstream in Jesus' name. By faith, I drink the blood of Jesus. You high blood pressure, I command you to be normal because of the blood of Jesus in Jesus' name. Dear heart, lay one hand on your head and the other on your stomach or your navel, and begin to pray like this. Say, Holy Ghost fire, burn from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Begin to mention every organ of your body. Mention your kidney, your liver, intestine, your blood. You must not rush at this moment because the fire will actually come. So by faith, say, Holy Ghost fire, burn from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Holy Ghost fire, begin to burn anything that is not of the Lord in my kidney, burn it out. Anything that is not of the Lord in my liver, blood it up, burn it up. anything that's in my intestine that should not be. Holy Ghost fire, burn, burn, run it out. Same with my blood. And again, dear heart, don't rush. Take your time. Because you will begin to feel the fire of God actually coming. And you'll be feeling like something in you trying to come out. And tell it to come on out in Jesus' name. Take your time. Don't rush. You're right there sitting comfortably in your home. And if you're not, I advise you, when you go home, to find the audio of this program and follow these instructions for your great deliverance in Jesus' name. Dear heart, say, I cut myself off from every spirit of, and I want you to mention the name of your place of birth. For instance, for me, I cut myself off from every spirit of Goldsboro, North Carolina, in the name of Jesus, because I found that as a little girl, everybody in the community, even my relative in the house where I was living, was involved in witchcraft. That land is polluted with witchcraft, and those demon spirits still roam those lands right today. So right now, you mention the name of your birthplace, say, in the name of Jesus, I cut myself off from every spirit of, and whatever the name of your birthplace you mentioned there, in the name of Jesus. Say, dear heart, I cut myself off from every tribal spirit and curses in the name of Jesus. Some of you, in your sins, you have gotten tattoos, you have gotten tribal piercings, and now you have come to Jesus. And you have never opened up your mouth to cut yourself off from that spirit that whispered in your ear to get that travel piercing and get those tattoos. So say right now, in the name of Jesus, I cut myself off from every travel spirit and curse that is associated with this travel piercing, that is associated with these tattoos, in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, burn, burn, burn the spirit that attached itself to these travel piercings and tattoos. And I thank you, Holy Spirit, that I'm no longer serving the spirit of rebellion. I'm no longer rebellious against my Lord and Savior. Because when we get travel piercings and tattoos, that is a sign of rebellion against God, because God forbid us in doing that. So again, say, I loose myself, I cut myself off from every tribal spirit and curse in my life and clinging to my life in the name of Jesus. Come on, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, burn, 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 burn. Come out in Jesus' name. Say, I cut myself off from every territorial spirit and curses in the name of Jesus. I loose myself. I cut myself, release myself from every territorial spirit and curses in Jesus' name. Say, Holy Ghost fire, purge my life completely in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, purge my life completely in the name of Jesus. Dear heart, say, I claim my complete deliverance, my great deliverance in the name of Jesus from the spirit of, and I want you to mention those things you do not desire in your life. Just take your time and think of everything that you do not desire to happen in your life, or in your family or children's life, and say, I claim my complete deliverance in the name of Jesus from the spirit of, and you mention those things you do not desire in your life. Say, I break the hold of any evil power over my life in Jesus' name. Say it, dear heart, aggressively. Towards the enemy, I break the hold of any evil power over my life in Jesus' name. And dear heart, you may be saying this over your life, but if you got children, their life is connected to your life. So when you loose yourself, you will be loosing and setting free your children in Jesus' name. Why? Because they are connected to you. Their deliverance is tied up in your deliverance because we are connected. Say, I move from bondage into liberty in every area of my life in Jesus' name. Say that, dear heart, aggressively. I move from bondage into liberty, which is freedom, in every area, not some area, but every area of my life in Jesus' name. Now, dear heart, say these aggressive prayers, mean it from your heart, and by faith, believing and receive your great deliverance in Jesus. Our great deliverance is only tied up in Jesus Christ. And as we receive him, he promised us great deliverance. Now, dear heart, I want you to thank God for answering your prayers. Thank God for listening to your prayers and answering your prayer. Thank him. Praise him. Thank him. Say, thank you, Jesus, for delivering me. Praise your holy name. I am free. I am free. Body, soul, and spirit. I am free, Lord. Because who the Son of Man set free is truly free indeed. And I shall maintain my freedom in Jesus' name because I choose to submit to God in Jesus' name. Now, dear heart, walk in your freedom daily on a day-to-day basis. Now, you are free, and the Lord said you truly have received. Now, he said you freely should give. Jesus has set you free. Now, you help someone else to get free. That is another way to maintain your deliverance by helping others to be free. Tell of the great things God has done for you by setting you free. Because we overcome the enemy not only by the blood of the Lamb, but also by the word of our testimony. So we praise and thank the Lord for our freedom today. Great deliverance is our lot. And we thank you and praise you, Lord Jesus, for our great deliverance. Dear heart, I'm your prayer host today, Evangelist King. And as always, thank you for tuning in, and I thank God for your freedom. And if you have any questions, feel free to send me an email at mightworks@thechildrensmight.org and visit our website at www.thechildrensmight.org. Dear heart, I praise and thank God for what he done. The young lady has shared her test. She got in contact with me. The Lord set her free from a spirit husband. And that young lady is free indeed. She's sharing her testimony. And God is continuing to do great things in her life. He's working on her husband. He shall be set free from that spiritual wife that he had. In Jesus' name, he shall be free, because the Lord promised us in his word, a sanctified wife will sanctify her husband. And he's coming to the Lord because of the work he's going to see God has done in her life. She has been truly set free from those demonic pollution that was in her, that was coming to her in the dream. Dear heart, you on the sound of my voice, monitor your dreams. If you are having sex in your dream, affairs in your dream, eating and drinking and partying in your dreams, dear heart, that is a sign of demonic spirits in activity in your life, and you need great deliverance in Jesus' name. So, dear heart, again, be sure to tune in to Shalom Prayer Teleconference, Monday through Friday, 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, by calling conference line 712-432-0075, participant code 422080. And again, the first 30 minutes is dedicated to the recording of the program. And then after that, if you desire personal prayer, then we could be able to, chat. But the first 30 minutes is for the recording of the program, because I share the audio with other listeners on our website. Again, I'm your host, and always remember, dear heart, in your getting to get understanding. Shalom.